And we're back after a brief break. You're watching South Texas Crossfire with Attorney Joe Flores. And, of course, I have the distinct pleasure of bringing on Joey Gonzalez, your commissioner, 24-7. Welcome, Judge. How are you?
Thank you, sir.
And I mean commissioner, too. Well, you know, I mean, you're like the Mexican Ben Franklin over here. I mean, you've done, you know, I'm a cop. I've done federal. I'm a commissioner. I mean, you've got 20 retirements. I mean, but anyway, you're still working.
I'm working on one more.
I think you should do about 5 terms as a commissioner. I really do. But anyway, what we're here for is to get out the vote 2012. So what have you been seeing out there in your precinct? People, are they excited? Are they wanting to come out and exercise their right to vote?
Well, I've seen a lot more people involved this time around, Joe, especially with phone banking and putting signs out and, you know, and knocking on doors and block walking, you know, and which is real good, you know. And, you know, and I think people have to realize, you know, and it is hard to say, well, my vote is not important, I'm not going to vote, because every vote counts. Every vote, you know, you can win an election by one vote, you know. And I think it's time for the people out there in the community, the Democrat Party, to wake up, you know, to start saying, hey, what am I going to lose? What's going to happen if I don't vote? And there's a lot to lose. I mean, you know, and some of you saw the debate, you know, between Obama and Romney.
It could have been better.
Could have been better, but you know, I look at it both ways, Joe. While Romney was very aggressive and came in strong,
especially about Big
Obama,
Bird.
President Obama told you the truth.
Yes.
And told you the facts and explained to you how he's going to do it, why he didn't do it. And Romney couldn't tell you that.
And what is the truth down here about what's happening with our seniors, what's happening with our education, and what's happening more bars and prisons? What is the truth?
The truth is that they're taking things away, and they're going to take things away from our seniors, you know, from our youth, from education. And probably our veterans too, because it right now they're having a hard time getting that money down to where it belongs, you know. So I think that it's time for everybody to wake up, you know. And I look at it in a way, in a sense, when I'm talking about Democrats, I belong to the Democratic Party, and we got people like Mark Skirka, we got people like Rose Harrison, we got people like Joe Benavides, you know, that are good candidates that are going to be there. They're going to be fighting.
And Joseph Ramirez trying to keep everybody together, putting us all together, uniting us.
Doing a good job this year. Joseph is really taking the bull by the horns and really, you know, reunited the
dynamic young man.
But you know, when I speak about what we're going to lose, I'm not just talking about Democrats. I'm talking about the community. I'm talking about people. I'm talking about Democrats and Republicans. I don't care if you know who you are. Look at what you're going to lose. Just because we always say Democrats are going to lose this. It's not Democrats going to lose that. Democrats, Republicans, individuals, or liberals, they're all going to lose this benefit, because every party has a middle class. Every party has a low class. Every party has a poor class. You know, so everybody's going to lose. Not just the Democrats, is the entire community, the nation as a whole is going to lose. And when a guy is running for president, I say guy, you know, I don't have a lot of respect for him, because he says 47% of the people of the United States are smooshers and their welfare, you know. And I'm sure he's counting me in those 47%, and I'm not, you know. So I think we have to be careful of who we put in office, you know. I think that if, you know, that for the last 18 months, Romney has pushed on trillions of dollars that he's going to take away, that he's going to, you know, he don't want to raise the taxes for the rich. You know, he talks about doing away with some of the benefits of Medicare. And all of a sudden he comes on TV, over a million viewers, you know, 63 million viewers, and he turns everything around and tells you what you want to hear. You know, and that's a lie.
For a vote.
For a vote. When people sit there and lie to 63 million people, how can that person be your president? You know, when President Obama was there and explaining why things weren't going to work and what is done, what hasn't worked, what he's tried to do, Romney could not even tell you, I have a plan, and this is my plan. You know, all he was saying, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, without telling you how he's going to do it.
Well, and all politics is local. Like Tip O'Neill said, great Speaker of the House, strong Democrat many years ago. It all comes back home. Okay, so here on the local level, what are you all doing? You've seen the results of a Republican-controlled supermajority in Texas. Zooming back down, you've seen what a controlled commissioner's court that is controlled by Republicans. What have you seen the devastating cuts? Especially, I've got exception, I'm going to bring on Mark Skirka and talk about it. The county employees and the district attorneys haven't had raises in years.
Well, you know, I was a long ranger on that one, and I'm really disappointed the fact that you know, the commissioner's court did
you
not.
You were in favor of it.
I was in favor of 2.5%, you know, and of course I got it voted and we went to 2%, you know, and it wasn't fair that only a group of people that they're you know, administration, department heads, and, you know, some of them got 14%, 10%, 11%, 9%. You know, that's not fair. When you're telling me the economy's bad, we can't afford 2.5%, but yet we're giving somebody else 14%, 13%, you know, 9%. How can...
And more consultants in the county? I mean, we got more consultants than the Viet Cong. I mean, you know...
Consultants making more money than we are, you know, so I don't know where...
I want to be a consultant, you know?
I want to be one, too. But, you know, the thing
you
is...
You were even willing to donate your car allowance, right? And, oh, everybody went crazy. I need that, what is it, $5K for a car allowance?
I'm donating $2,000 on my car allowance back to my special project, so it goes back to the community. So I'm doing already. I'm already giving it. And I challenge everybody not to take the 2%. And, of course, I was outvoted on that one, too. You know, so, you know, and the other thing is, Joe, you know, we went from a 10%. They went from a 10-year retirement to an 8-year retirement. Why? Who is it going to help?
I want to go work there. 8-year retirement.
It's only help a handful of politicians.
Yeah.
It's always going to help.
That's right.
When I brought it back up to bring it back to 10 or 12, I mean, it's like, man, it was like I said something real wrong. And, you know, I mean, I was looked at like, hey, you don't bring this up. You know, we're not going to discuss that. I don't want to hear that.
Well, you're messing up Lloyd Neal's deal, huh?
Well,
if you bring that up.
He's going to retire.
He's going to retire out anyway.
8 years. But
right.
I'm looking at the future of the community. The future of our taxpayers, the future of our workforce in the county, because really the workforce in our county are those people in the bottom, Joe. I mean, if we can't afford to give them 2.5%.
They're making $8-9 an hour. They're making $300 a week for their family.
And then they say, well, everybody can retire at 8 years. Well, maybe they can retire at 8 years, but on what?
On what?
I mean, you know, at least some of us will make a good retirement because we make good money. You know, but how is anybody in the bottom echelon that's barely making it, retire in 8 years and make it in $200 a month?
You can't.
So it's ridiculous, you know, and you know, it's not, you know, sometimes we vote party lines and it shouldn't be that way. It should be what's best for the people of this community, regardless of who you are, Republican, Democrat, individual. You know, we have to take care of everybody, you know, in the long run. But I think I'm going to remind those people, lo que decía toda la gente que está oyendo hoy, que si no votan, no se quejen.
Así es cierto.
Porque si acaso no votan, entonces no tienen que quejarse. Su voto es su voz. Si no quieren perder lo que tienen ahorita, lo poquito que tienen, entonces tienen que votar.
Y también recuerdo a la gente que el Partido Demócrata no es el partido del pobre, es el partido
de todos.
De todos, de justicia social para todos. Bien
sí.
Dicho.
Y lo más que tenemos que saber es, uno dice, no, pues no tengo en qué ir, no tengo tiempo. Hagan tiempo. Ya, si hablan el teléfono, por favor, lo van a levantar para que vayan
we'll
a votar.
We'll go pick you up to vote.
Yeah, sí.
Yeah.
Pues muy, muy fácil. No hay excusa porque no pueden votar. No hay excusa.
Absolutely no excuse.
Comienzan los early voting el 22 de este mes. 22 por 10 días pueden votar en muchos lugares. You know, so no hay que, you know, cuando van a comer, ahí pueden votar muchas veces. Cuando van comprando otras cosas, ahí pueden votar. Agarren tiempo de votar. Su voto es muy importante porque me van a quitar la educación a los niños, le van a quitar los beneficios que tiene, el Social Security, le van a quitar el welfare, le van a quitar más, de todo le quieren cortar. Lo primero van a hacer todo lo que reciban los beneficios. I'm telling you now, if you don't vote, when you come neck down around and you're going to lose some of those benefits, you know, don't be complaining that why is the government doing it? Well, it's doing it because you didn't vote. You know, we need
really
your vote.
Well said.
We need your vote. You know, the people that are there, not because they're Democrats, but people that are there, they're in office now. You know, you got your DA that's doing a great, great job in this community. You know, Joe Benavidez that works hands-on with the community. With the
gunny.
Youth. You know, the Rose Harrison that wants to make sure she's fighting for women, fighting for welfare, fighting for all these good things that has to do with the community, with the lower people, with the middle class, lower class, and nobody cares about.
Right.
And I'm going to say nobody cares about because when Romney makes that statement, I'm going to say it again, that 40% of the voters support President Obama on welfare. And that is not true.
And that was a very dangerous statement to say. But I'm going to let you get back to, you've got a meeting with some judges at noon. I appreciate you taking the time out from also out there in Benavides. And I would listen, you're doing great things out there, even providing them with transportation and everything that you do for education is our freedom for the youth. Any last second words? Dave's pulling the cane on us.
Well,
you know
I
he
just
is.
Want to say that you know, we're having a health fair at Banquete on the 10th of October.
And there'll be some more in case we air this on October 20th or something.
We got free shots, for flu shots, free immunization shots. So bring your kids over if they haven't got their shots so we can get their shots. You know, and sponsored by my precinct, sponsored by Texas Health Science School. But also, just real quick, Joe, remind you that the people that are in office now are doing a good job. People, you know, you might want to change some things. You're the voter. You can change wherever you want. If you think they're doing a good job, you change them. You know, but you cannot change it unless you vote.
Right, and don't just pull the lever. You know, the Republicans say Democrats do that. Yeah. I think it's the exact opposite.
And I remind again, those that are listening, whether you're Republican, Democrat, or not, you vote for Romney, you're voting against your own population that's middle class, lower class, that's poor, regardless of who you are. Because you're voting for somebody that wants to take away things from your family, from your children, from education. We're going to lose more teachers, you know, and this is something...
Romney won't care if you're a 75-year-old Republican. You're going to get cut,
or
right?
Or Ryan won't either. Ryan has said, you know...
Oh,
Ryan,
yeah,
Ryan's
look at that
Ryan's
guy.
Ryan's already doing it already.
Oh, yeah, he's got his plan. They've got their agenda, and they didn't become rich overnight. And I don't think there's that sense of otherness like we have with Obama.
Right.
So I think that it's better to be safe than sorry. So anyway, Joey Gonzalez, your commissioner, 24-7, hopefully for about another 12 terms. What do you think, 48 years you're going to serve?
Let's get rid of this one first, and then we'll talk about
All right, that's what I'm talking about.
Thank you,
well, thank you for coming back. We're going to take a little break. When we come back, we're bringing on a couple of powerhouses from the Democratic Party. When we come back.
Hola, soy Joe Flores, abogado, pidiéndole a la comunidad hispana que se formen parte del Partido Demócrata. Los demócratas son conocidos como el Partido de Derechos Civiles y Derechos para Todos los Hispanos. Grupos como LULAC y el GI Forum iniciaron en Corpus Christi. Republicanos quieren quitarle derechos a niños y mujeres y programas importantes. Involúcrese, regístrese para votar y recuerde que el Partido Demócrata no es el partido del pobre, es el partido de justicia social para todos.
Call River City Hospice for your loved one's care today. River City Hospice is a compassionate, patient-centered healthcare provider with a unique approach to medical care and support for people at the end of life and their families. River City Hospice focuses on maintaining dignity, increasing quality of life, and providing comfort and reducing pain due to illness. Hospice care allows your loved one to be treated with dignity and respect and gives them the right to choose. Call 882-5900 today. Hope, dignity, and love. It's got to be River City Hospice.